Welcam back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple 3D model in SOLIDWORKS with the help of isometric view. Here you will learn multiple things like extruded boss base, extruded cut, and some feature tools of sketch. Now this is the drawing. This all dimensions in millimeter. I'll upload this drawing in my FB page. You will get the link in description below. So let's start to create this one. Now let's open here file, new, and choose your part. Okay, now see, this is SOLIDWORKS interface. Now we are in the SOLIDWORKS interface. Let me see, some change some background, documents, property, image quality. You can keep slower, and this is also slower, but it increases the sharpness of image. Now this is the drawing. So first we will create the base. Base radius, center distance 60 mm, and radius 25, and extrude thickness 12 mm. Now so let me choose top plane, sketch, go to sketch and choose here center point straight slot. If you drop down this menu, you will find center point slot. Start with origin point, drag any one side. Okay, right click, select. Now make sure it is vertical or horizontal. 60 mm this length, and the radius is 25 mm. See, isometric view, exit, and simply select extrude. This thickness you can keep here and condition blind, and thickness you can select here 12 mm. Okay, now here this radius we will create first. Radius is same 25, this circular part 25 means 50 mm diameter, and the inner hole diameter is 10 mm. Then this cutout is 12 mm, but this cutout only up to 6 mm. Let's see how to make this one. Choose this face, sketch, take the normal position, select here circle and draw one circle. Now what we will do, select these two circles, make first concentric, then equal. See, if you choose circle diameter, it's by default 50 mm. Extruded boss base. Now we want to extrude. You can even drag with the help of this arrow also, but better to keep end condition, and here define your length 20 mm in upward direction. Okay, see, select the top face, sketch normal. Now here one hole. If you keep your cursor here, you will find a center point. Just click. Now let me choose some up to here. Let's make one center line. Select mirror entity, choose this line, select here copy, mirror about this line. Okay, first select the line, make sure it is horizontal. Now we need to, okay, let's define, this is also 12 mm, this radius 10 mm, means diameter 20 mm. Okay, now select this outer circle, convert entity, otherwise you can simply click circle and draw one circle. Trim entity. Now we need to trim many things. Choose power trim, just press left key and drag this side, this side, inside, inside. That's it. This is enough for us. Okay, isometric view. Now first we will make this cut this hole, then this outer cutout. So let's see how extruded cut. Now here it will ask you if there is more than one closed geometry. So it will ask you selected contour. So let me choose 1, 2. And this blind condition either keep through all 30, 40 millimeter, see, or simply choose here through all. Through all means it will cut up to end. Okay, that's it. Even we can define this raw material, polished steel, so dark, a light color nickel, brushed nickel. Okay, now here choose this face, sketch, or simply exit. We need to forget to do one important thing. Select this sketch, extruded cut. Now again it is asking you selected contour, so this time we will choose this face 2, 3, 4, and this length only 6 millimeter downward. Now see, it's going bottom side up to 6 millimeter. Okay, oh wow, look, sketch, now we will expand this one, this outer radius 12 millimeter, inner 6 millimeter, but the center distance is not given, so we will consider 12 millimeter, and it is the center point with outer one, and extrude up to 4 millimeter. Again choose straight point slot. Just go here, and here you will find a center point. Okay, draw one more, this center point up to here is small. A sketch. Now this outer radius 12 millimeter, inner radius 6 millimeter, but the center distance, it is not given in drawing, so we will choose 12 millimeter. Now see, extruded. Now the closed area going to upward, in upward direction, thickness 4 millimeter. Okay, but here there is a cutout, so what we will do, select this face, this sketch, convert entity. Now the inside one is converted, go to feature and select extruded cut through all. Okay, now that's it, the hole is created. At the bottom there is a hole 6 millimeter and 20 millimeter wide throughout hole. So for this we will choose any one, let's say this right plane. A sketch, normal, corner rectangle. Okay, let's define 6 millimeter width and the length 20 millimeter. Okay, now we need to define, we need to make it in center position, so choose this center of rectangle, hold shift key and center of origin, vertical relation. Now see, it is seems fully defined. Extruded cut. Now this time what we will choose, okay, let's increase one side. Here you can choose direction too. I just want to show either you can directly select mid plane or through all, both it's effective. Now see, we need to cut through all both, so here we selected direction 1, direction 2. Okay. Now see. So this is how we created a simple geometry in SolidWorks with the help of isometric view. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.